this man. Like, I'm done.
Good morning. It's Monday. Sun's out. Mondays are awesome because this is a time where we set new goals, new adventures for the week. We got 5 listings in this week from Whitby to Bowmanville. So we just want to make sure that everything is on track, the staging, the cleaning, photography, all of our systems are in place. So that's my goal that I'll go over with the team. I'm excited to hear their goal. This team is on fire right now. And I'm always excited just to hear what they want to accomplish this week. We got tons of clients on the go. We got to be careful though. There is a robin looking after her babies. Get a shot of that nest up there. Don't go too, gosh, and watch yourself. Don't go too close. So it's risky using this door right now. They've unlocked the side door, but anyways, let's head in. Let's check out the team meeting. I'm excited.
Okay, so my Bowmanville listing is hitting the market next week. Stacy is heading over to the property today. She's doing her consult. The clients do want to paint, maybe switch out some light fixtures. So she's just going to offer suggestions there.
Okay.
So that's really just my goal, just to make sure that listing looks absolutely amazing when it hits the market and all the services get booked properly.
All right, this one's a big one for me. I want to book 4 new listing appointments with some brand new sellers, 2 by Wednesday, 2 by Friday. And if I can't, I'm going to be sleeping here until I do.
What time?
Game time!
Am I rolling this the right way? I do this every morning, and I don't know if I'm doing it the right way. Okay, so there's a fine line between like setting goals like that are realistic and unrealistic. And I'm the first one to push people. I don't want people to just set easy goals they know ahead of time they're already going to hit. But you know, Bailey's goal is bordering on the edge of, I don't want to call it unrealistic because he's amazing and he's trying to push himself. But what I'm saying is you just don't want to set yourself up for failure. Not saying he's going to fail. I'll be rooting for him. But this will be exciting to see if he can actually fulfill this goal. This is a big one. This is something he's never accomplished. I know he'd love to. We'll see what happens. I'll be cheering him on at least.
Okay, Stacy. Oh, Bobby's listing? Oh, because you're supposed to be staging that. Okay. Okay, let me talk to Bobby and I'll get back to you. Okay. Somehow the house is painted the wrong color.
No.
It's supposed to be white and somehow it's got like a little shade of blue.
Oh my God, they're gonna freak.
Was this your listing?
Yeah.
Yeah, they ordered the white color that we told them, and somehow it's got like a
wrong.
Yeah, it's got like a shade of blue or something. So Stacy got there, and all of her accessories, they don't match. Color palette is completely off now.
Yeah, what time is the photos at?
Tomorrow morning.
Okay, so we have like 12 hours then to get one of our painters in to repaint it then.
And then stage before pictures.
Yeah, Stacy's got to juggle that.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's up, man?
Not too much, man. Just waiting on a phone call. Hopefully I can solidify one of these appointments. Oh, look at that. I'll be back.
All right, man.
All right, so I'll call the painter right now then, and I'll arrange with Stacy the new stuff, and we'll let our clients know the new schedule.
Yeah, and if one of our painters can't come in, then you and I are getting on our painting shoes. I don't even know. It doesn't even make sense, but we're going to be painting.
I can't wait to see that.
Hello, Bailey Goggins speaking.
There is a legal case being filed under your name and the rest.
So, the scenario like Bobby right now.
What the?
And what's going on with her listing, you know, the fact that it was painted the wrong color. We've pretty much seen everything. We have, you know, over 20 years combined experience in this office. This is honestly, it's all about how you react, how you can pivot from one situation to another. And that's the amazing thing about having this team and, you know, being able to leverage each other is getting something like that, you know, some people that might be a disaster to the listing and delayed for a week where, you know, we have our contacts, our vendors, like this will be corrected today, which is amazing for not just ourselves, but our clients, right? Because they deserve the best service, the best, you know, value for their home. And we'll stick to the plan. This actually won't throw us off at all. So again, it's just about how you can move from one situation to another, like really, really quickly in this business. Ash, we got another registered offer on our Oshawa listing.
Okay.
Just notify front desk, let all the agents know.
Okay.
What's up, Nicole?
Oh, not much. Just got to our Wiki listing. And
okay.
There's some shingles on the grass. I looked up. There's about 6 to 8 missing shingles on the roof. I'm assuming from that windstorm last night.
This man. Like, I'm done. This is insane today. Is there a full moon out? It's 11 a.m. There's no moon out. Okay, we got the drone going there today.
Yeah.
Ash, what time's the drone in our Whippy listing?
It's supposed to be there at 3.
Okay. I'm going to call. It's obviously bad. You noticed it. I mean, there's shingles in the grass.
Yeah, you noticed it right away.
I'm going to call a roofer, Sean, see if he can literally jump off. I'm sure he's at another roof right now or on another roof. I'm going to see if he can get over there ASAP and just patch this.
All right, sounds good.
Okay.
I'll measure and head back to the office.
Okay, thanks so much.
No problem.
Bye.
Take care.
Bye. Bye, you're going to call Sean. I'm going to call Sean.
Bye, me calling Sean. You're going to call Sean. Thank you.
I know you can't do Saturday at 1, but maybe how about Monday at 2? My schedule is kind of clear then. That doesn't work either. Monday at like what, 4 o'clock maybe? Or maybe Tuesday?
Hey, do you have a minute?
Yeah.
Okay, I just wanted to just touch base about the Bowmanville listing. I just got off the phone with the sellers and they said the paint looks absolutely amazing now. I know. Joey was able to get in there like super, super quick. So they were just really happy that he was able to, you know, accommodate our schedule and just get in there ASAP.
Yeah.
I'm actually heading over there like really soon to take a peek, and just because Stacy's there, I just want to see it all tied together. Are you able to pop by at all?
Yeah, I was actually going to head there right after this last appointment. So
okay.
I will meet you over there, I'd say like probably an hour.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, that works out great then.
Okay, that's awesome. That's such good news.
Perfect. Okay, I'll see you in a bit then. Okay.
I'll talk to you.
Okay, bye.
Hello, Bailey Godwin speaking. Okay, yeah, sure. I can definitely come over to take a look at that for you. Give you some better ideas what the process looks like. How is tomorrow at 1:30 sound? That works for you? Awesome, perfect. I'll see you then. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.
So overall, this week was crazy successful for our clients, which that's really always the end goal. When you set goals every week like we do on our team, it doesn't necessarily mean you're gonna hit every single one. The fact that Bailey still booked a listing appointment put himself further ahead than most people in this business within the competition. So I'm super proud of him. And we set goals really to just keep ourselves accountable and keep us on track. We wanna be the best of the best in this business, and I think we're on the right path to do that. Excited to head into next week. Stay tuned for our next vlog. What's up, Joe? Check this out. This is when you know you've done a good job. My clients know I'm a massive Raptors fan. One of the best client gifts I've ever gotten. Replica championship Toronto Raptors ring. I wear it on every listing appointment now.